Hello, I'm Knight of Christ Jesus here. My knowledge and your IQ isn't sufficient. We need the grace of Almighty Father. Therefore, let us begin with a prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, bless and bestow upon us your grace. And let this learning process be helped and guided by your Holy Spirit, so that the knowledge acquired here be used for peace and prosperity of human race. Let this race be the pride of Christ Jesus. Lord, thy kingdom come. Amen. Hello. This session, we shall apply the chain rule to the multiple angle of the trigonometric functions. Consider y equal to sine of ax plus b. So this is a trigonometric multiple angle. So this be equation 1. Then differentiating with respect to x, it is going to be a chain rule. So there you would be having d by dx of y equal to d by dx of sine of ax plus b. Now we know that d by d theta of sine theta equal to cos theta. This is a formula. D by d theta of sine theta equals cos theta. When you apply here, this whole thing is like theta. So therefore you will be getting dy by dx equal to, this will become cos theta. Theta is nothing but ax plus b. So it will become cos ax plus b. But this is not x, therefore it will be a chain rule into d by dx of ax plus b. When you do this, you will be getting dy by dx is equal to cos of ax plus b into d by dx of ax is nothing but a into d by dx of x plus d by dx of b, which is a constant. So when you take this one, this is going to resolve to cos of ax plus b into a into 1 plus 0, because differentiation of constant is 0 and differentiation of d by dx of x is 1. So therefore this overall results to this is into, it will become a plus 0. So that a can be taken further down, or I'll take it down here. So d by dx of sine ax plus b will be equal to a into cos of ax plus b. But you have an alternate form also. In case if this b is not there, that is, if it is d by dx of sine of ax alone, where a is a scalar or a constant, then in this case it will become cos ax into d by dx of ax, which is going to be cos of ax into a. So therefore this can be written as a into cos of ax. So therefore d by dx of sine of ax equals a into cos ax. Thank you. this session, we shall do differentiation by chain rule for multiple angle of cosine function. So consider y equal to cos of ax plus b, b equation 1. Now differentiate this with respect to x, then you will be getting d by dx of y equal to d by dx of cos of ax plus b. So when you differentiate that, but we know that d by d theta of cos theta is minus sine theta. So therefore, applying this formula over here, we'll be getting dy by dx is equal to, this is going to be minus sine of ax plus b into d by dx, that is the chain rule for ax plus b. So when you apply this one, you'll be getting minus sine of ax plus b into a plus 0. Because d by dx of ax is going to be, take the constant out, a, differentiation of d by dx of x is 1 plus d by dx of b, which is constant, it will be differentiation of constant is 0. Therefore, you will be getting 0, a plus 0. Therefore, multiplying it, you will be getting minus a into sine of ax plus b. That is nothing but your d by dx of cos of ax plus b. But you have the other version. Say for instance, if you have d by dx of cos of ax, this will be minus sine of ax into d by dx of ax. Therefore, this is going to be minus of sine of ax into a. This can be written as minus a into sine of ax. So therefore, d by dx of cos of ax is nothing but minus a into sine ax. Thank you. This session, we shall do differentiation by chain rule, the multiple angle for tan function. Let y equal to tan of ax plus b. This be equation 1. So differentiating this with respect to x, we get d by dx of y equal to d by dx of tan of ax plus b. So when you differentiate, you will be getting dy by dx is equal to differentiation of tan theta. D by d theta of tan theta is nothing but secant square theta. So therefore, you will be getting secant square ax plus b. And into by chain rule, you get into d by dx of ax plus b. So this will result in secant square of ax plus b into a plus 0. Because differentiation of ax is a into d by dx of x, which is 1, plus differentiation of b, which is constant, is 0. So when you take this forward, you will be getting d by dx of tan of ax plus b is equal to a into secant square of ax plus b. And the other version, when you take, say for example, d by dx of tan ax. So this is going to be, secant square ax into d by dx of ax, which is going to be secant square of ax into a, because d by dx of ax is a itself. So therefore, you will be getting d by dx of tan ax equal to a into secant square ax. Thank you. This session, we shall do differentiation applying chain rule to multiple angle of cot function. So consider that y equal to cot of ax plus b, b equation 1. Now differentiate this with respect to x. You will be getting d by dx of y equal to d by dx of cot of ax plus b. So this will be equal to dy by dx is equal to differentiation of cot. Cot is nothing but minus cosecant square ax plus b into d by dx of ax plus b. So this is going to be, therefore you will be having dy by dx is equal to minus cosec square ax plus b into a plus 0. So therefore you will be getting d by dx of y equal to, that is y is nothing but cot of ax plus b, we'll write it off here itself now. This will be equal to minus a into cosecant square of ax plus b. But the other version, d by dx of cosecant ax will be equal to minus, cot of ax will be equal to minus cosecant square ax into d by dx of ax. So this will be equal to minus cosecant square ax into a. So therefore d by dx of cot of ax will be equal to minus a into cosec square ax, that will be the final. Thank you. We shall see the differentiation by chain rule, the multiple number of secant function. So let y equal to secant of ax plus b be equation 1. Differentiating with respect to x, we get d by dx of y equal to d by dx of secant of ax plus b. So therefore, this will be equal to dy by dx equal to d by dx of secant theta is secant theta into tan theta. So therefore, this is going to be secant of ax plus b into tan of ax plus b, and by chain rule you have d by dx of ax plus b. So when you do this one, you will be getting dy by dx is equal to secant of ax plus b into tan of ax plus b into a plus 0. So this can be rewritten as this, the final statement will be d by dx of secant of ax plus b, secant of ax b equal to a into secant of ax plus b into tan of ax plus b. The other version would be like d by dx of secant of ax will be equal to secant of ax into tan of ax into d by dx of ax. So this is going to be secant ax into tan ax into a. So this will be equal to, therefore, d by dx of secant ax will be equal to a into secant ax into tan ax. This will be the final version of it. Thank you. Chain rule of multiple angle of cosecant function. So let y equal to cosecant of ax plus b be equation 1. So differentiating with respect to x, we get d by dx of y equal to d by dx of cosec of ax plus b. Then you get dy by dx equal to differentiation of cosecant theta is minus cosec theta into cot theta. So therefore it will be minus cosec of ax plus b into cot of ax plus b, and then the chain rule. So d by dx of ax plus b it is called. So therefore you will be getting dy by dx equal to minus cosec of ax plus b into cot of ax plus b into a plus 0. So finally you will arrive at d by dx of cosec of ax plus b will be equal to minus a into cosec of ax plus b into cot of ax plus b. That is the final version of it. The other form will be d by dx of cosec of ax will be equal to minus cosec of ax into cot of ax into d by dx of ax. This is going to be minus of cosec ax into cot ax into a. This will be equal to minus a into cosec of ax into cot of ax. So therefore, d by dx of cosec of ax is going to be minus cosec ax into cot ax. No, minus a into cosec ax into cot ax. Thank you. Shall differentiate using chain rule for log of ax plus b and see what it is. So let y equal to log of ax plus b to the base b. This be equation 1. Now differentiate this with respect to x. So you get diff WRT x. You will get dy by dx is equal to d by dx of log of ax plus b to the base e. So this differentiation of log x is nothing but 1 by x. So therefore you will be getting dy by dx is equal to 1 divided by ax plus b into d by dx, that is the chain rule, into d by dx of whatever is in the bracket, that is this one. So we'll be getting dy by dx is equal to 1 whole divided by ax plus b into, this is going to be a plus 0. So therefore d by dx of log of ax plus b to the base e is going to be a divided by ax plus b. The other version of it without b would be d by dx of log of ax to the base e will be equal to 1 by ax into d by dx of ax. going to be 1 by ax into a. This a and a gets cancelled. So therefore you will be getting d by dx of log of ax to the base e is going to be 1 by x. Thank you. This session, we shall apply chain rule to e to the power ax plus b and see what we get. Let y equal to e to the power ax plus b. B equation 1. Differentiate with respect to x. You will be getting d by dx of y equal to d by dx of e to the power ax plus b. So this is going to be dy by dx equal to d by dx of e to the power x is e to the power x itself. So therefore you will be getting e to the power ax plus b will be e to the power ax plus b itself into the chain rule d by dx of ax plus b. So this will result in dy by dx is equal to e to the power ax plus b into a plus 0. So therefore you will get d by dx of e to the power ax plus b will be equal to a into e to the power ax plus b. The other version will be d by dx of e to the power ax will be equal to e to the power ax and apply the chain rule into d by dx of ax. So therefore this is going to be e to the power ax into a, which is nothing but d by dx of e to the power ax is going to be a into e to the power ax. Thank you.
My heartfelt gratitude for this video, viewers. May God bless you all.